I am surprised that you agreed to do it. Why are you sitting down with us today?
I'm very tired of all of the lies. I've been hearing things and, you know, and seeing things on the blogs. And, you know, I'm just tired.
What are the lies that you're hearing that disturb you most?
Oh, my God. All of them. Got little girls trapped in the basement, helicopters over my house, trying to rescue someone that doesn't need rescuing because they're not in my house, handcuffing people, starving people. I have a harem, what you call it, a cult. Mm-hmm. I don't even really know what a cult is, but I know I don't have one, you know.
Have you done anything that you regret? Have you done anything wrong?
Lots of things wrong when it comes to women that I apologize, but I apologize in those relationships at the time I was in the relationships.
Have you broken any laws when it comes to women?
Absolutely not.
The six-part series interviewed 50 people, family members, your former tour manager, numerous women who all claim that you abused them. Yeah. Are you saying everybody in that documentary was not telling the truth about you? Everybody?
If you really look at that documentary, which I'm sure you have.
I have.
Everybody said something bad about me. Nobody said nothing good. Mm-hmm. They was describing Lucifer. I'm not Lucifer. I'm a man. I make mistakes, but I'm not a devil, and by no means am I a monster.
I'm going to name the names. Andrea Kelly, your ex-wife, Kitty Jones, Lisa Van Allen, Lizette Martinez, Geronda Pace, Faith Rogers, Asante McGee. You're saying everything they said in that documentary about you is not true.
They are lying on me.
Why would these women say the same thing about you, that you are controlling, that you are abusive, that you tell women when to eat, when to go to the bathroom, when they can sleep, where they can dress? Why would all these women tell these different stories about you if they were not true and they don't know each other? That defies logic to me.
Right, right. Until you hear the explanation. You can start a rumor on a guy like me or a celebrity just like that. All you have to do is push a button on your phone and say, so-and-so did this to me. R. Kelly did this to me. And if you get any traction from that, if you're able to write a book from that, if you're able to get a reality show, then any girl that I had a relationship in the past that it just didn't work out, she can come and say the same exact thing.
Are you blaming this on social media?
I'm talking about the power of social media.
Have you ever had sex with anyone under the age of 17?
No.
Never?
No.
I have to tell you, it's so hard to believe that based on all that we've read.
I'm gonna tell you something, Gayle. There's one situation. I'm gonna tell you something.
What women said about you?
What women said about me? What women? So nobody's allowed to be mad at me and be scorned and lie on me.
So they're lying on you. That's your explanation. They're lying on you.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Absolutely.
You feel that people have maligned your character?
I have been assassinated. I have been buried alive, but I'm alive.
So I think the point you're making is, and correct me if I'm wrong, that you have never held anybody against their will.
I don't need to. Why would I?
Well, I'm
how stupid would it
never
be
held
for
anybody.
R. Kelly, with all I've been through in my way, way past, to hold somebody, let alone 4, 5, 6, 50, you said. How stupid would I be to do that?
I didn't say you were holding...
That's stupid, guys! Is this camera on me?
Yes, it's on.
That's stupid! Use your common sense. Don't forget the blogs. Forget how you feel about me. Hate me if you want to, love me if you want, but just use your common sense. How stupid would it be for me to, with my crazy past and what I've been through, right now I just think I need to be a monster and hold girls against their will, chain them up in my basement, and don't let them eat and don't let them out unless they need some shoes down the street from their uncle.
Robert,
stop it. Y'all quit playing. Quit playing.
Robert.
I didn't do this stuff. This is not me. I'm fighting for my life. Y'all killing me with this. I gave y'all 30 years of my career.
Robert.
30 years of my career! Y'all trying to kill me! You killing me, man! This is not about music! I'm trying to have a relationship with my kids, and I can't do it! Y'all just don't want to believe the truth. You don't want to believe it.
Robert.
You just don't want to believe it.
At this point, we briefly pause the interview to give Kelly a moment. His publicist helped calm him down. But Kelly's emotions remained very raw.
I hope this camera keep going.
No, we're going to let the camera keep rolling.
This is not true. This doesn't even make sense. Why would I hold all these women? Their mothers and fathers told me, we're going to destroy your career. Robert. It's real girls out there missing. It's real young girls out there being abducted, being raped, okay? They really are on chains. They really do have chains on their wrists, and they can't get out.
Robert,
and they're ending up buried in deep.
Robert, we have to have a conversation.
This is
really
not me.
I don't want you just ranting at the camera.
I came here for them to hear me talk.
Okay, but
I need help.
What kind of help?
This is the kind of help I need.
Yes, what kind of help?
I need somebody to help me not have a big heart. Because my heart is so big. People betray me, and I keep forgiving them.
You sound like you're playing the victim here. You sound like R. Kelly, you do. When I listen to you,
I'm just
it does
telling
sound
the
like
truth.
You're playing the victim
I'm
card.
Just telling the truth. And the reason I'm emotional,
but Robert,
and I apologize for that,
is because this
is the first time I was able to say
speak.
Something.
Yeah.
I've said nothing.
Your income, it was reported that your income was very high. Hundreds of millions of dollars, we'll say that. Because I don't want to get hung up on
now,
the
semantics. That's one rumor I wish that was true.
And yet, when you were in jail last week, the bond was $100,000.
Mm-hmm.
And they said R. Kelly couldn't even afford to get himself out of jail, that a friend had to come and bail you out of jail. What is your financial situation, if you don't mind saying?
Here's the deal. So many people have been stealing my money. People was connected to my account. I went by myself for the first time to Bank of America. Didn't know what I was doing. Didn't know what the hell was going on.
When did you do that? First time by yourself?
About 3 weeks ago to a month.
3 weeks ago was the first time you went to Bank of America?
Absolutely.
By yourself?
By myself. Because I was so tired of not knowing where my money was, where my publishing is.
Isn't that on you?
A lot of it's on me.
That you didn't know where your money is?
A lot of it's on me.
And people say he doesn't have money because he had to pay so much in settlements. What do you say about that?
Lie. $350,000 in the bank. And I told her, look, take that. I'm going to start a new account, and that's the way it is, right? So she said, okay, it's going to take 6 to 7 business days to clear. Does that make sense? How can I pay child support? How? If my ex-wife is destroying my name and I can't work, how can I work? How can I get paid? How can I take care of my kids? How?
Your ex-wife
Use
says...
Use your common sense!
Your ex-wife says you abused her, Robert.
13 lying! 13 years being married. I flew in on a helicopter.
Yeah, yeah.
I flew in on a helicopter.
Yes. Yes. Can somebody get us some tissue?
I don't want no tissue. I'm going to leave.
No, you're doing well.
Look, man, look. I'm telling y'all. I flew in on a helicopter with a damn puppy, and I proposed to Drill, whom I was in love with, and told her, hey, look, I make mistakes. I'm not perfect. We got married, okay? We had 3 beautiful kids. Not once have I ever had a domestic violence call at the house and all this, that, and the other. It never happened, okay?
Is Andrea not telling the truth when she says she was abused by you? She not telling the truth?
Absolutely. She's not telling the truth. I love her to death. I have nothing against her still. That is my kid's mother.
She's making that
up.
You
notice one thing.
Why is she making that up, Robert?
I'm not disrespecting her by saying she's not telling the truth. I'm just being honest. Somebody sent me something on my phone and said that I hog-tied her. I don't know how to hog-tie people. What would I hog-tie? My kids is listening to this, all of this nonsense, and I ain't been able to spend no time with them. This is real. This is not a lie. What kind of woman will tear down a dad who's trying to have a relationship with their kids? You know how many kids need a relationship with their father?
What is your relationship with your children?
Oh, my God.
What is your relationship with your children?
Zero.
Zero.
But I know my kids love me. And I'm in love with my kids. I love my kids.
What is your relationship with them?
I love them, and it's almost, it's like they're my girlfriends. It's like, you know, we have a relationship. It's real. Mm-hmm. And I know guys, like, I've known guys all my life to have 5 or 6 women, okay? So don't go there on me, okay? Because that's the truth.
The fact that they're much younger than you.
I don't look at much younger than me. I just look at legal. I just look at you're you, I'm me. Now, I don't know if you're married. I don't know. I don't know if you had a relationship. I don't know what you, you know, I don't know. Mm-hmm. But one might be older than the other. Mm-hmm. One might be younger than the other, mm-hmm. Okay? So I just look at legal. Okay, people. There are older men that like younger women.
Is that
there
true?
There are younger women that like older men.
Are you an older man that likes younger women?
I'm an older man that love all women.
Okay.
I didn't go looking for a Jocelyn Savage. I was doing my show. He brought her and asked a friend of mine to put her on the stage with R. Kelly. Make sure she's on the stage.
Mm-hmm. Azriel Clary, what is your relationship with her?
Right now, I'm seeing her.
You are seeing her?
Yeah, she's 21. I'm seeing her.
She's 21?
Yeah.
But did you start seeing her at 17?
Absolutely not.
Did you have sex with her when she was 17?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Although her parents wanted me to.
No, her parents claim they have text messages that show that you had sex with her when she was 17.
Claim.
So you're saying you did not have sex with her when she was 17?
Absolutely not.
You are with 2 women right now. You love them. They say they love you. What kind of love is it that keeps these young women away from their families? Their families are saying...
When you're talking
about these... I'm talking right now about Jocelyn
and Azriel.
Because you
know, I'm going to answer your question.
What kind of love is that?
What kind of father? What kind of mother will sell their daughter to a man?
Who did that?
How come it was okay for me to see them until they wasn't getting no money from it? Why would you take your daughter? If I were going to take my daughter and she's 19 years old to a 49-year-old icon, whatever, celebrity or R. Kelly concert or whoever it is, I'm not going to put her on the stage and leave her. I'm going to take her to the concert. Their father is more into my music and know about my music than they do.
You're saying the parents handed their daughters Azriel and Jocelyn over to you? Is that what you're saying to us?
Absolutely. Are the cameras still going?
Yes.
Absolutely.